Are you feeling overwhelmed with this thing here? The idea of being on camera. You think you want to be on camera? Maybe you've started doing some live, but you feel overwhelmed because you don't know where to start. You have all these ideas. You know video is powerful, right? You've heard that by 2020, 80% of internet traffic is going to be video. You've heard that video gets customers to trust you and you need to do video for your business. You hear about these YouTube stars. You see all these amazing Facebook videos that are growing people's business. But you don't know where to begin. Do you know what I'm talking about? Because I've heard it from a lot of people. It's overwhelming. There's so many options out there. What do I use for a camera? What software am I supposed to use? What's the difference between live streaming and recorded video? Which one should I do? Should I be on Facebook? Should I be on YouTube? What should I be doing? What's a playlist? I know it's overwhelming. It is. There's a lot to think about. So I'm Michelle Osorio. I'm a YouTuber and a live streamer. I've been doing it for many years. And I wanted to give you some tips if you're feeling overwhelmed because there's too many options out there. All you know is you're supposed to be doing video, or maybe you've started and there's too much going on. It's a noise in your head. So I can give you a few tips to get started. And this is recorded live. Hi, Katya. Thanks for joining. And it's part of this playlist I'm doing where I'm recording live and I'm tackling a subject for each video about getting started with online video, the strategies and the production and the promotion for your business, putting your videos online. So if you're overwhelmed and you don't know where to start, usually people ask me things about gear or platforms, such as should I do YouTube or Facebook or Medium? Should I be doing live stream or pre-recorded video? They tend to be questions like that. Or what kind of camera do I need? What is the gear? What software do I need? Those are all the questions I get when people are just starting out. And it's almost like it's a curse that we have too much information because there's so many options out there that if you're just getting started and maybe you're trying to get your business online or start tackling online video for your business, there's too many things that you could choose from. So my advice, having been on YouTube for 12 years, having 134,000 live stream followers, is you need to actually take a step back for a moment. First, breathe and do a little thinking and a little writing first. I know everybody just wants to hit the ground running, they just want to go. But if you take the time to do a little bit of research, a little bit of working on yourself, thinking about what it is you want to accomplish, you are going to be light years ahead of the people who just start trying to do everything and be on every platform everywhere and buy thousands of dollars worth of equipment and they're not ready. So the first thing you need to do is first identify your ideal client or your target audience. A lot of people have already done this for their business, but if you have not, identify your ideal client. And I spoke about this on my last video where when you get on camera, you need to imagine that ideal client. So it all starts with that. So hopefully you've already done that. If not, I have other videos about identifying your ideal client that you can check out. And just make sure you follow my page or my channel, Dare to Dream School with Michelle Osorio. Once you know your ideal client, what you should do is figure out where they hang out. That's how you're going to answer the question, what platform should I start with? And you should start with just one platform, my friend, because there's a lot to learn. So trying to be on Facebook and Instagram and YouTube and Snapchat and Musical.ly, TikTok, it's going to be even more overwhelming. So choose one platform and it needs to be where your ideal client hangs out. That's it in terms of choosing the platform. So your next question might be, okay, but what if I don't know where my ideal client hangs out? That's totally fine. The next thing you need to do then is to ask them. If your business already has existing clients, then just ask them, call them up on the phone. Email them. If you have in-person meetings, just do a quick assessment, do a quick survey. Say, hey, Where do you hang out the most? Facebook, YouTube? Where do you go? How did you find me? Where do you go when you need to ask your questions related to my business? And where do you go to learn? Where do you go to consume content? And that's where you want to be making your videos. If your customer says, oh, I mostly look for tutorials on YouTube, you need to be on YouTube. If they say, oh, mostly I watch so-and-so's live Facebook show every Friday, and that's where I get all the tips and tricks for the industry, then maybe you should consider Facebook. Ask them, are they in Facebook groups? You know, what do they do? What do they do online? What are their activities? If you don't have clients that you can ask, that's totally fine. You can run surveys. So what I did for my new business, Dare to Dream School, trying to figure out where people hang out, is I went in Facebook groups that were related to my business, and I just asked them more information. You know, obviously they're on Facebook already, but I was able to send out actual surveys. You can do surveys for free with Google Forms and with SurveyMonkey and Typeform and those kind of services. And then just ask the main questions you need, like, you know, what do you need to learn? Some other things we'll cover in other videos. That's how you're going to find out what to make your videos about. So make sure you check out my future videos about what to make your videos about. It's what your ideal client is searching for and trying to learn. But one of the key questions you need to ask there is, where do you hang out? So it was helpful for me because I was able to see, yes, my audience learns mostly from YouTube. They watch lots of YouTube tutorials, which is great because YouTube is my wheelhouse. So I knew I was on the right track, but it's very helpful to do surveys. Okay, finally, if you're having trouble with surveys or you don't have clients to ask, the last thing you do is just do an internet search. If you think they might be on YouTube, go look up YouTube videos of questions your ideal client might be asking or information they might be searching for, and then go see how popular are those videos? What are the questions people are asking in the comments? Are people really engaged in the comments? Or check out Facebook, check out Instagram. Go scope out other people who have business models that are maybe similar to yours in a similar industry. And just do some reconnaissance. If you do this work ahead of time, you're going to be so much more well off in terms of being prepared before you tackle it. So once again, this answers the question. I'm overwhelmed. I don't know where to start. Where you need to start is identify your ideal client. 2, find out where your ideal client hangs out. Once again, you get that from, what was it? You get that from talking to your clients. If you don't have clients, run surveys. And then if you're having, you're still having trouble, although surveys are really good, you just got to find those people. If you're still having trouble getting people to your surveys, just start looking around the internet. Start hanging out in those platforms, LinkedIn, Facebook, Instagram. And then, you know, see how popular that stuff is. It doesn't have to be hugely popular. It just has to be enough where you think you can gather leads from that platform. And then decide. Then you're going to want to choose one platform to start. And that's how you get started with video. Now you know where to begin and only do one. That will keep you from being overwhelmed. Once you have chosen, I highly recommend that you just stick with what you got in terms of equipment. That will also help you not feel overwhelmed. So make sure you just start with your phone. If you have a smartphone or you maybe you do have a camera, but you think you need to buy the latest, newest camera, I wouldn't. I would start with the phone. Start simple and first just stack, you know, the first basic things, which is, you know, making videos that people want. Starting to gather an audience, understanding maybe you're not going to get a lot of views in the beginning. That's okay. But people overwhelm themselves because they're trying to do too much. So if you just practice that for a few months, making videos or making live streams, if you've decided that your ideal client prefers live streams, just do that very simply first. And only then can you start thinking about upgrading your equipment. But try only to learn a few things at a time. So just work on your strategy. Just work on your scripts for a while. don't try to do too much, because you know, you don't want to try to learn equipment and gear immediately, and then it's editing software, like, all at the same time. It's too much. And you know, you don't want to set yourself up to fail. You want to set yourself up for success. Give yourself some quick wins, shooting phone videos or phone live streams, and then work your way up. So that's how you set yourself up to not feel overwhelmed. Do one thing at a time, one platform at a time, master that platform, only stack the equipment and software complication on top a little bit later when you feel good about the strategy, the scripts, you started to build an audience. If you just learn a few things at a time, that's really what you want. And make sure when you're ready for the equipment and the gear, when you're ready to step up, make sure that you start with your, I think you should start with your audio, but I will have another video that I'm going to do. So make sure to check that out about what equipment you can begin upgrading and my recommendations for where to start with that. All right. Thank you, Dare to Dreamers. Never give up. Always dare to dream.